restricted lane. In a restricted lane, that could be posted as a preventable accident. If truck wasn't in that lane, be no accident. Chattanooga. We're going west on Interstate 24. Here's your posted speed limit. It's going to be 55. And there's a 40 mile an hour rollover sign down here. What a lot of drivers do is they come into this curve and then they put their brakes on while they're in the curve, which is not a very smart thing to do. We're going to move over to the left one more time. I'm going to show you this rollover sign and give you an idea of our speed with your truck. See here, we're starting to hit this thing. There's a flashing sign up there. There's your rollover sign. Like I said, here's your flashing. So, and he's hitting this thing at about 67 miles an hour. That is pretty fast. There's a lot of rollovers here. You look at all those skid marks in the pavement. Here he is putting the brakes on. And you get yourself into a jackknife situation putting the brakes on in a curve like that, depending on the conditions. You might get some uneven braking and so forth. That sign over there says end truck lane restriction. So now by default, he's in the proper lane. We come out of that thing about 65 or so. I'm gonna move on over to the right. We gotta come up here and get a truck number for you. We're just letting you know some of the decisions your drivers make could determine whether J.R. Schrugel here has to deal with a rear end collision or an abrupt lane change collision. I'm sure they wouldn't like to see either, but the way we got this guy got our attention was he was running up our tail. We moved out of the way, he ran up on that wrecker, and then decided to run the restricted lane. Here's our current location. Chattanooga, Tennessee. Right now it's 39 minutes after 8 o'clock, that is Eastern Time, and today's the 1st of December.